Okay, hello everyone. My name is Andre, and then in this video tutorial, we want to make Maze Runner game with Scratch. And then you can access the Scratch platform in scratch.mit.edu. Okay, let's start begin. In the first step, we need to prepare our backdrop first for the track of our sprite here. It's like a mess, and then our sprite will avoiding the obstacle of the mess, and then touching the finish line here in the red line. Okay, you can make the backdrop with this line. Okay, you can choose fine, and then you can choose line, and then you can make your own backdrop or your own track for the Maze Runner game like this. You can change the color here, and then you can change the size of the line here. Okay, I have the backdrop before that I prepared before this video, and then for the second step is choose your sprite. Okay, you can choose your sprite with this menu. You can choose your own sprite. There is some category that you can choose, like animals, people, fantasy, dance, music, and many more. Okay, and today I choose a cat for our sprite. Okay, let's start to third step is move to block code. Okay, in this step we can choose the block code. There are many menu block code in here that you can using the menu and the block depends in your needed. Okay, first we choose in even menu is when click block. Okay, when click block, when green click, this is our green flag. Okay, next we must to know that our sprite is have an position. You can see the coordinate here. Okay, the coordinate is the point of the position sprite, which is there is a point X and point Y. Okay, every we move our sprite, the value of the coordinate will be changed. Okay, you can see in here. Okay, this is our first position for our sprite in here. Okay, okay, the rules of the game: if our sprite touch the black line, our sprite will be back in first position in here again, and then if we touch in red line, our sprite will be say you win. Okay, okay, and the next step we need in a new motion, we need this block. Go to X and Y. Okay. The point of X coordinate is always left and right. If you move your sprite left and right like this, the coordinate, the X point will be changed. The value will be changed. And then the Y coordinate, it's always up and down. If you move your sprite up and down like this, the coordinate, the Y coordinate or Y point will be changed like this. Okay, so for the next step, we need a event block when K press. Okay, when K press, we can change the arrow like this. Unit up, and then you can duplicate or Control C, Control V, or in the MacBook you can press Command C and Command V like this. We need 4 key press, and then change the arrow. Up arrow, down arrow, left arrow, and then right arrow, like this. Okay. This is a key press that you can press in your keyboard. So if we press up, the spread will be move to up position. And if we press down arrow in our keyboard, the spread will be move to down. Okay. For the controlling the move, we need to change x by 10. Okay, or change x by 10 and then change y by 10. Okay, change x by 10 is for left and right row like this. One thing that you must to know, the left arrow always negative value, and then right arrow always positive value. Okay, if you look in our sprite, the effect like this, you can see in here the value of X will be changed. And then up arrow is always positive value, and then down arrow always negative value like this. If you press your keyboard, you can see in here the Y, the value will be changed. Okay, now we need a control that if our sprite touching the black line, it will be go to in our first position. So you can choose if then logic block, and then move to sensing, touching color, and then you can choose the color with color picker here in the black, and then add motion, go to our first position. Okay, and then you can add logic block here. If the our sprite touching the red line, our spread will be say you want. You can move to looks and then say you can change the string. You win for the second. Okay, let's start the game. Okay, you see if our spread touching the black line, it will be back to the first position. Okay, and then if our spread touching the red line, it will be say you win.